left aside. Again, it's Chara. And Chara able to shake free this time. Outlet pass is on now for the control of Horton. Gave it back up to Lucic, and a shot is blocked aside, and down on the ice now is Horton.
This one's a whole lot of nasty. Aaron Rome comes up and just delivers a crushing open ice hit.
Oh, Nathan Horton is in some serious trouble right now. Nathan Horton lets go of the pass, and that is a late hit by Aaron Rome after Nathan Horton had distributed that puck to Milan Lucic.
On the try from Krejci, score! Just one to the outside. Thrown in front, Beverly scores! Lost it, poked away by Marchand. Dances to the outside, takes his own pass. Marchand along in front, score! Brought on by Ryder. Ryder a shot, guided out another chance, score! Krejci! Maier brings it back in, score! Was off of Marchand, out in front, score! Recky! Go! This is another goal scored by Kelly. Make it seven. Score, Michael Ryder.
That to this day is still one of my favorite things. I just absolutely love it.
We were playing against Colorado, and I think it was Alex Tanguay tried to turn around and ice the puck. I think we were on the power play, and clipped me with a high stick.
Wow, hurt right in the mouth.
I was slowly going to the bench with my trainer, and a fan who was sitting right on the glass started to heckle me, and just started calling me some names and that I really can't say on TV.
There's Steve Sullivan gets cut, and the fans just giving it to him. And you know, and you know what? I appreciate when fans pay their money and they get to boo, they get to cheer, they get to act up, and within limits and everything else. There's a guy who takes a puck in the head and you're just giving it to him through the glass. And to me, I kind of think that's kind of gutless.
Watch Patrick Waugh. Watch the puck that goes around. Bonk. It hits something. And now Sullivan comes over. This is the fan. The same fan who was giving Sullivan a hard time. And that's his wife laughing with the thumbs up.
And luck be it, Patrick Waugh got the puck behind the net and threw it over the glass. And it clipped the same fan right in the forehead, and he started bleeding probably worse than I was. And Antonio Monte yelled at me on the ice that it was the same fan, so I just took it upon myself to go back and tell him a few words of my own.
Road game against a powerful defending Stanley Cup champion that has won three in a row. Lucic over the line to Chatan, the shot up high, it goes over Fleury's goal. And Chatan is down in the high slot, and I did not see it. I was following the puck, Brick, but tempers are rising down in the corner. Here's the hit.
Well, right side of your screen is the release by Savard, and then the left shoulder, and the elbow was tucked pretty low, wasn't extended. This will give you another idea here, but that's a target head hit. That how can there not even be a penalty on the play?
He's not trying to separate him from the puck there. He's trying to separate him from his consciousness.
But these guys won the Stanley Cup, and they're the champs until somebody derails. Look now, and here comes Kane. And Kane's going to go right after.
Oh!
He's out. Cook is out. Oh, my gosh. He said, you want to chase me around? Western Canadian kid. He's thrown him before, but he wasn't going to take on a guy like Goddard.
Wow.
Cook, the ice here.
Cook is challenging him. And so, but he's smart about it. He didn't take the first guy that asked him. He took the right guy. He one-punched him. Bam! Oh, man. That's as good a hockey punch as I have seen in a long.
I was watching the puck in the zone as well.
Got hit by Ruutu.
Now he comes back. Sorry, but we know what
funny
happened there.
Sid, the kid, acting like one. Watch Ilya Kovalchuk. Ah, he was going to retaliate. Doesn't. Give him a little shot. Shot back. Slash. Whack hack. Now watch. Trash shot. Ilya Kovalchuk goads Crosby into a penalty.
At that time.
There's Melby, far side to Modric. Remember though, whether Gretzky was like that when he was that young. I know it was later. Here's Hossa holding it. Far side. Kovalchuk beats it. Scores again. Kovalchuk.
And that's how a kid like Crosby will learn.
That's great stuff. Don't forget, I think this all stems from, remember the hit, watch his point. He's pointing right to him. Ah, it's awesome. He's telling him. And you know why? The hit in the first period, Crosby on Kozlov, Slava Kozlov. Ilya Kovalchuk.
Left bomb against Lindholm. In deep, Zach Kassian gets bumped hard by you-know-who, Tkachuk. And Cassian's mad, and here we go. Now there's going to be penalties in the game. They've been going at each other on and off all night, and Zach Kassian is incensed.
Now, we showed earlier in the first period the one hit that knocked his helmet off, and I don't know if you could hear, but it was McDavid yelling at Kassian to have his head up.
To go in the period. So he was coming down pretty fast, but he turned before the hit.
Right on cue, as we talked about the battle of Alberta, and here these two go out of guard, and Cassian's throwing all of them.
Richards looks to center, hits off the side of the cage. There is a Bruin injured. It's McQuaid as Thomas fakes the stop on Carl. And now some extracurricular activity with McQuaid down.
Watch the awkwardness here of Adam McQuaid. He leans and he's expecting something up top. Richards moves. All his weight is at the top on that miss. And once his legs get caught up, I mean, he goes crashing into those boards.
I don't think he knows how to play. I don't. It seems to me he's like a player that just feels he can get the puck because he's tremendously skilled, can skate. He has all those things, as you guys know. I just think he thinks he can go do whatever the hell he wants on the ice. You can't do it in the National Hockey League. And, we have spent a lot of time trying to teach him situational play, away from the puck, all the stuff we do with players. Sometimes it looks like he's understanding. So in a roundabout, to answer your question, I don't know. I don't know if he just can't comprehend it or he's just stubborn. But he's running out of time.
For Pageot to Savard, moves to the middle a little more for Duclair, scores! Anthony Duclair, the hat trick and the overtime winner! And the power play kills them, and this time it's Duclair with a one-timer and a beauty as Shabbat will move the offense over against the flow, or the defense rather, and find Duclair wide open here. He'll push everybody over. And here he'll dance to the left and then pass back against the flow for the one-timer, and Duclair with the hat